find out, I asked Johnny, the basis of treasures, to answer a couple of my questions. He kindly invited me back to his house. I wanted to find out what he thought about music piracy and the effect it has on local bands. The lane that shakes, you feign me there. Put my hand in my hands to evade your stare. Cause I shall never speak to my bones so well. No, I'll never speak, no, I'll never tell. But the rain came down and it washed me away.
I'm always gonna say music industry. I don't think that music piracy is a problem for local bands, like, at all. I think that piracy has done local music in whole like a massive favour by actually just being there, because it makes sure that the local bands are finally not charging so much money for the music they're trying to record. It's just all coming out for free, so people are getting their name out there quicker. People are really starting to appreciate them, like, music for its music rather than everyone whining about the price that it's costing.
Yeah, I definitely think it's obviously a good thing for, like, unknown bands, because obviously then they can get their music out there to people who haven't heard them. But for, like, mainstream bands who their goal is, like, they're already out there, then they obviously want to make some money out of being big and famous, so piracy is a bad thing for them.
Yeah, treasures are basically, we're just four guys that get on better than brothers, really. We'll just really, really get on. But, like, I think the thing that we've got is that we're not afraid to write the slow songs that local bands are, like, afraid to do. We're not afraid to say certain words and really express the way we feel about our music. And to be fair, like, we'll play to one person the way we would play in front of 1,000, really, just because we're doing what we love and just trying to get our music out there. I mean, obviously, albums as local bands, like, they cost a fortune to make, but you need to be the kind of band to give that out, you know, for free. You need to give something back to the fans. So I think that as a local band, I would like my band to give the music back to the fans for free. But if, you know, if you're going to get signed, you're heavy touring, you were away from, like, your home for a very long time, you know, I think that albums should be sold at a certain price, you know, but not as much as they're being sold at the moment.
Since the decline of file sharing programs such as LimeWire and Napster, a successor has emerged: torrents. Torrents allow you to download anything from the latest music to the classic blockbuster films, and it's all for free. So what's the harm? Is the campaign slithered in jails in the cargo bay? A new turd is a vastness, hollow vacuum, choppy oxygen tanks. They hibernate, but have they kissed the ground? Pucker up and kiss the asphalt now. This amputation's winter layering shit has access now. From what I've seen on the Pirate Bay's website, the torrent scene seems very much alive. I wanted to find out what Nick Beeney from Treasures thought about music piracy and its effect on local bands.
Well, it is stealing, pretty much, because bands are paid to have their stuff recorded, like, the record labels are paid, and the people download it for free. Like, that's pretty much stealing, isn't it? So I feel it kind of, like, ruins the opportunity to make money for themselves. Like, if people are downloading songs illegally, then they're not getting any money. I don't think the music industry would crumble because of the piracy and that, because there's plenty of people in the world who are going to want to buy CDs. Like, people have different views on things. Some people believe that, yeah, piracy, you know, who cares, like, you might get in trouble for it. And some people believe it's wrong, so there'll still be money going into it and that. As we get bigger, like I say, yeah, I'd rather get paid for it, because it's our time going into it, and we'd like to get something out of it. So we pay for all the equipment for ourselves, so we'd like something in return.
So there's a clear divide in the merging.
Even band members directly affected by music piracy have contrasting opinions. For the next few days, I followed Treasures around to practice each other's houses and general band-related stuff to try and get a better picture. From the facts I've read and the people I've met, they are definitely in it for something other than money. I went to Jonnie's house with Nick to see what they thought of each other's views. They didn't seem to care. One constant underlying feeling I got from both of them, despite their stance on music piracy, was that they just love to make music, and to them, at this moment in time, that's all that really matters. So how does music piracy affect local bands? Well, I don't think it's them you should be worrying about. Jonnie and Nick invited me to their first gig they played together as a band. It's there I saw this financially carefree attitude and eternal passion for music shine through, which gave me a better ending for my documentary than I could have by reading a bunch of newspaper articles and blogs. It was pretty inspirational.
Time. find us. Thank you.